All right, so this week we're talking all about everyone's favorite word, moist. This is a word that's gotten a lot of bad press in the last couple of years, so this week we're talking all about one very effective way to get rid of moistness in your home, and that, my friend, is the bathroom fan. So you're thinking of updating your bathroom. You have a bunch of decisions to make, like what type of flooring, sink, vanity, toilet you're gonna pick. But have you thought about the number one thing that'll make that bathroom the healthiest bathroom to do your business in? That's right, it may sound boring, but bathroom fans are way more exciting than they're made out to be. They're responsible for your well-being inside the room where you get naked the most often. Now, before we dive in, throw us a like and hit that subscribe button to get more sustainable home improvement videos just like this one. Now, if you're listening to this and have a bathroom but don't have a bathroom fan, then listen up too, because in this video, we're gonna take a deep dive on bathroom fans, all that you need to know when buying, and a closer look at some installation considerations. Of course, it wouldn't be a Rise video without looking at the health, wealth, and planet impacts of this product category. So if you're ready, let's do it. So you're either thinking of a bathroom renovation or maybe you're due for an upgrade. Bathroom fans have been around for decades, but what are they exactly? What is a bathroom fan? A bathroom fan is an exhaust type of ventilation system that grabs moist air and odors from your bathroom and brings it outside. Ventilation like this is necessary in order to avoid excess moisture, mold, mildew, and rot from happening in your home. Unfortunately, for many older homes out there, bathroom fans are the only real means of mechanical ventilation. That's right, if you don't have an air exchanger in your home but have a bathroom fan, chances are that is the only way that you're exhausting stale air from your home to the outside. Now, it's very important to realize that bathroom fans function solely as an exhaust. That means your bathroom fan isn't responsible for bringing fresh air into your home. It's only responsible for bringing your business smells to the outside. So it's still important to get other forms of mechanical ventilation into your home by way of an air exchanger. The real key benefits of a bathroom fan touch primarily on your home's health. It's directly responsible for managing moisture levels and removing odors from your bathroom. It might also be good to know that mold and mildew spores are among the leading causes of respiratory diseases, asthma, and other allergies affecting millions of people across North America. Now, high humidity levels also create ideal conditions for pests such as cockroaches and dust mites. The biggest pitfall to bathroom fans, though, is that they're typically a retrofit option, which means you're having to create a new hole in the side of your house in order to use it. That does play against your home's air tightness, and you'll want to consult an experienced pro to do the job. Most all bathroom fans complete the same function of getting rid of excessive odors, humidity levels, and even mold spores that accumulate in a bathroom's moist environment. However, there are slight differences based on where the fans are mounted, how they expel the moisture and air inside bathrooms, and any extra features they might include. Ceiling-mounted fans, these are the most typical installations, just like this one, are recessed inside a ceiling cavity and exhausted through ductwork to the outside of the home. Wall-mounted fans are also fairly common and attached directly to an exterior wall. Some folks complain they're maybe prone to backdrafting and don't do quite as good of a job at capturing that rising moist air. Exterior exhaust fans are fans mounted on the exterior of a building and are much more common in commercial applications. Inline exhaust fans are built in and refer to whole home systems like HRVs and ERVs that replenish bathroom air with fresh air to other rooms of the home. Bathroom fans that include lighting fixtures are versions that have built-in LED lighting, and some even now have Bluetooth speakers built in if you really want to geek out on some tech. Some of the more recognizable brands in this category include Panasonic, Delta, Newtone, and Braun. Now, once you've nailed down the type of fan that you'd like to use, next is finding the best one to suit the space. The best way to figure that out is by looking at two clear indicators, CFMs and SOHMs. Bathroom fans are rated by their CFM rating, which is their cubic foot per minute indicator, also known as how much air can be moved in under a minute. Generally, a more powerful fan will yield better results, but you don't want to overpower your room with an enormous fan either, or pay more for a larger fan than you might not need. And typically, the higher the CFMs, the louder the fan. Now, there's actually a quick and easy way to figure out just what size fan you need with this simple math equation, and all you need are your room's rough measurements. So let's say for a small bathroom that is 9 feet long by 5 feet wide and 8 feet tall, you simply multiply those three numbers and times it by 0.13. This will give you the minimum CFM rating required for that room. That said, you should also factor in the loss of CFMs for the amount of ductwork that needs to be installed. Typically, you can factor a 7% CFM loss for every 25 feet of flexible ducting, just like this, and 3% for every 90 degree turn. In this case, we need a fan with a CFM rating of at least 44 to properly manage the air in this room. The fan we chose has two settings, one for 80 and one for 110 CFMs for plenty of additional pull. All right, so the second indicator I mentioned is zones. This is essentially the indicator that tells you how loud your fan will be. And fans will usually be under 3 zones. This is a tricky question because while a lower zone number means a quieter fan, and there are fans out there that are literally whisper quiet, there are still many folks out there that want to hear something, especially if your bathroom walls aren't totally soundproof. Sometimes having a loud fan, especially in bathrooms that guests would commonly use, is doing you and the visitor's service, if you know what I mean. So once you feel good about the CFM rating and the zone level, look for the Energy Star label. This is the bare minimum, by the way. The requirement for bathroom fan efficiency is still pretty low to meet Energy Star standards. The other is looking for an HVI label, which stands for Home Ventilation Institute. This is a body that certifies home ventilation products and, for bathroom fans specifically, certifies that the manufacturer details are actually what they are when it comes to CFMs, zones, wattage, and lighting. Now, when it comes to installing your bathroom fan, it can get pretty tricky pretty quick. The ease of install will largely depend on where your bathroom is located inside the home, whether or not there is an existing fan and ductwork, and whether there is wiring already in place or accessible. Now, we're in the middle of an upper floor renovation here, so installing the fan above meant getting around a few feet of blown-in cellulose in the attic to install the exhaust, and climbing to the outside for the exterior vent. Now, one quick note about older homes and fans vented to the attic, make sure your venting actually goes to the outside. We do see a tendency for older homes to have their exhaust stop in the attic and not make it to the outside, which can cause an abundance of issues in your attic space. And right below this bathroom is a powder room, and so while we're adding a new fan and ductwork to this room, we actually took the opportunity to swap out the fan in the bathroom below, which is accessible through the floor joist here. Now, the size of these boxes will vary depending on the size and type of fan, but you'll want to make sure that your joist span is wide enough to support the fan box. But without going into the full install details here, I want to stress that this is a job that's best suited for an electrician, and we do encourage you to hire out for this job and budget at least a couple of hours of labor to have a fan installed. So what's the typical cost of a bathroom fan? Well, like anything else, there's a wide price range to choose from, but typically for a small bathroom, you can get a pretty efficient fan for about $100 to $150. Now, keep in mind, that's just the price of the fan itself. You'll need to have it wired in, installed, and vented to the outside by a licensed electrician. And you may also need to do some drywall patchwork if you're switching out an old unit, which again adds to the price. In the end, the bulk of the price is actually in the install and accounting for spare parts like exhaust ducts, wiring, and switch installations that brings the cost of a bathroom fan closer to the $300 to $500 range for a fully operational fan. Now keep in mind, there are also a few things you can do to save on the cost of running that fan moving forward. Try choosing a model that, at a bare minimum, has an Energy Star rating. And going a step further, look for a fan that has a high CFM per watt rating. Some models go as high as 19 CFMs per watt, so try to find one with a rating of at least 10 CFMs per watt. That means the more efficient models use about as much energy as a typical LED bulb. Another trick to limit your spend on bathroom fans once you own one is to set it up on a timer. This is a fairly common practice nowadays, and it ensures that the fan does not get left on unnecessarily while the bathroom is not in use. Lastly, I want to spend a second to talk about the planet impact of bathroom fans. Products in this category in general, regardless of manufacturer, are generally very similar in the materials used and sourced. The majority of these fans are made of molded plastics and lightweight steel, so it's nothing too innovative and for the most part takes quite a bit of energy and resources to create. There is also a majority of these products that are made overseas, but if you can spot a North American made version, it's a great way to reduce the footprint and overall embodied energy that comes from owning one of these products. Also, choosing a version with high CFMs per watt, at least 10 or more, is another great way to reduce your impact from its daily use, which will also result in savings to you. All right, there you have it, guys. I hope you enjoyed all the moistness and that you learned a little something about bathroom fans along the way. Did we miss anything? Or maybe you have some experience with bathroom fans that you'd like to share? Please let us know in the comments below. And as always, find more sustainable home improvement tips and research at buildwithrise.com. Thanks, guys, and we'll catch you on the next one. Thanks so much for tuning in, guys. For more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe by clicking the button below. And also check out buildwithrise.com, the only place to turn any home improvement project into a sustainable one.